The union movement's actually chosen today to protest outside the WorkCover Authority because it hasn't delivered results for injured workers.
We had a reasonable system of workers' compensation that people worked to get here in 1985. Kennett got in and gutted it, and then when Brax got in, he put a little bit back to it, but not very much. It seems to have become a system where you help employers, because in the last 4.5 years, what you've had is $2.9 billion worth of premium cuts to employers.
WorkCover makes a profit of more than $1 billion a year and pays more than $700 million into the state government coffers.
No organisation, and that should be making a profit out of injured workers. This organisation makes a profit of $1.2 billion.
Last December, the state government perhaps recognised that, we hope that's the case, and they announced the Hanks Review into the 1985 Accident Compensation Act. Peter Hanks, a QC, was asked to conduct the review. He's finished his review and he's given it to the Minister for WorkCover, Tim Holding, today.
And now, this chance we had with the Hanks Review, everyone assumed would be the chance where this would we would be able to fix the workers' compensation system up again. And so it would go back to being a system that assists workers who are injured.
If the government implements the Hanks recommendations, as we've seen them, it will mean that WorkCover will get much worse. The recommendation will, amongst other things, block 90% of stress claims. Now, a number of the unions that are here today are from unions where stress is a very high level of the claims that they do. Certainly from my point of view, from the Australian Education Union, that's the case. The recommendations also take out of the legislation employers' return to work obligations for injured workers and make it much harder to resolve disputes over claims. There are also documents that suggest that perhaps it's had an undue influence.
It's extraordinary that in June of this year, the Victorian WorkCover Authority had a document that demonstrated what was going to happen and when it was going to happen. You've got the Victorian WorkCover Authority, who's not only the regulator, but it's the decision maker in regards to workers' claims for compensation. And they're the ones that are determining what goes to Parliament and when it goes to Parliament. Now I ask you, is that a proper process? I don't think it is.
We need to get some of that $1 billion a year, and we need to give it to those people who need it.
And we need to call for real beneficial change, and if we can't get it under a Labor government, when are we going to get it?